Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. Let's take a look at creating disk images using Disk Utility. So to create a disk image, we're going to use the Disk Utility app. Now you can find this by going to your Applications folder and then going into Utilities, and there's Disk Utility. But of course, the best way to do it is just Command Space and search for Disk Utility and run it that way. So to create a new disk image, you can use this New Image button here at the top, or go to File, New, and create a blank disk image. And then you give it a name and save it just like a regular file to a location, because a disk image is in fact just a file. Inside that file, instead of having, say, graphics or a word processing document or something like that, you have a whole bunch of other files. But you're going to see it as just a regular file, and this is the file name. This is different than the name down here, which is the name you'll see when you mount the disk image, and we'll just do it, call this one test disk image, and we'll see that name appear later. You can set a size for it, and you can also set a format. I would just leave it here for most uses. You can also encrypt it, and you can have a password, and then this password can be used to protect the files inside there. This is great if you want to create a disk image to put a bunch of files in and then email to somebody and you know it's protected. And then you can also select different formats. You can do the rewrite disk image here, but you can also do a sparse disk image, which will shrink the file size to the minimum it needs. It'll still look like it's a 100 megabyte disk, but the file itself will be a lot smaller. So let's create this. And it'll create, and it'll put it out there. And then at this point, we're kind of done with using Disk Utility to create it, and we want to actually interact with it in the Finder. So we go back to the Finder window here, and we'll take a look, and we'll see under Devices that test disk image is actually here and it's empty. We can actually put files in it. Let me just open up a second Finder window here and just grab a bunch of files, and I'll put it in there. And notice it's going to copy them in there, because it's like this is a separate disk drive. Even though it's a disk drive on our main disk drive, it's treated as a separate one, so automatically it's like copying to a USB flash drive or an external drive. And that's what I've got in here. Now I could look under Documents here, and there's that file called test.dmg, and you can see it's 100 megabytes in size. And even though I'm not using all that space, it'll just be that size. Okay, so now I've got the entire disk image here as a single file here in my Documents folder. And then if I look in the drive, I've got all the stuff inside it. I can hit the Eject button here and it goes away. I still have the file, the single file, but I can't access the files inside it at all. It just sits there like a single file, which is one of the main reasons to use a disk image. Say you have a project that has thousands of files and you're done with that project, and you're sick of seeing these show up in Spotlight and searches, and you're sick of just having all these extra files in your drive, and you just want to kind of encapsulate the entire thing into a single file which you can put away in some sort of archive. You can create a disk image like this and put all the files in there. To get into them, I just double click on it, and it's actually going to then mount that drive, and there it is, and I can get to those files again. Since it's a read-write image, I can remove files, delete files, interact with this just like it was an external drive that I had plugged into my Mac. And notice that the name of the drive here on the left sidebar and here at the top is that name that I entered in, not the file name, not test.dmg, which doesn't appear anywhere in the name of the drive. It's almost like labeling a USB flash drive by writing on it. That's not going to appear here in the Finder. It's going to be the actual official name which I gave to it. So let's go into Disk Utility now and see that there's another option. You can actually create a disk image from a folder. So this is a quick way of doing it. I can select a folder, like say this folder with a bunch of pics, create an image, and I could save it out. And in one step I've created this disk image here. And when it's all finished up, I can go into my Documents folder. I can look at the pics folder there, and you can see that not only did it just create it very quickly, but it made it the exact size it needed to be to hold those files. Now let's create a new disk image that is both going to be a sparse disk image, and also it's going to have encryption set. And I'll call it new image here, and I'll call the file something similar, and you can see it's going to append .sparseimage as the extension. I'll hit create and create it in the documents folder there. It's going to ask me for a password. I'm going to assign a really weak password there, and then I'm going to turn off remember password and keychain. This is great to have turned on because it means you'll never have to enter the password in again on your computer. So you send this to somebody else, they'll need to enter it in. I'm going to turn it off just so I can demonstrate having to enter the password in. And it's going to create this new sparse image. Now I stuck with 100 megabytes as the size for the sparse image. So you can see there, it's a new image right there. And I go in and you can see it still thinks there's 100 megabytes available. I'm going to grab some files here and drag them in right there. So I've copied them in and now there's 5 items in there. I'm going to then look at the documents folder, and you can see in the documents folder I've got this new image and it's still pretty small because it'll adjust in size. I'm going to eject the new image drive so it's no longer mounted. I can no longer access it in the Finder, and then attempt to mount it again. And when I do that, I double click on the file there, it's going to ask me the password, and I don't have access until I enter the password in. And not only is it password protected, but it's important to realize it's encrypted, which means that the files simply just are all garbled until you enter that key in, which is the password. So it makes it hard or almost impossible for somebody to get. Great for if I wanted to send these files encrypted to somebody else on a Mac who could then just get this single file disk image and enter the password in and then get access to these files.